All right, guys, I'm all retied up. Let's try this again. No, don't like that. There we go. Too much. My hands are shaking. Sorry. Looks better. Yeah. Get you in there nice and easy. All right. Cast number two. Doing this on camera for the first time ever is kind of a trip for me, so here we go. All right, let's try it again. Lots of bluegill swimming right here on the shallow end. I see a bass right over there. This one was playing games with me last week. Let's see if she's hungry today. You messed with me too much the other day. Sorry if I'm not in the shot, I'm not used to. Ooh! There's a jumper. Hold on, let me. Okay, let me turn this because I'm going to fish right here. shaky camera. Here we go. I don't know. See that ripple in the boil right there, guys? Oh, right there too. Yeah, they're feeding. They're hungry now. Let's see what we got. Been having a lot of good luck with that lately. All right. Let's see what I can do right over here. The lay down's right there. Oh, that's an ugly cast, but we'll see. Ooh, maybe not. That was right there in front. Come on, fishy fishy. Let's go. You're on camera. Pretty warm out right now. Guys, it's about 2:30 almost, 2:22 on a Thursday afternoon. Oh, there you are, just sink, baby, sink. So they had to lower the water out because they are trying to eliminate a lot of the moss and the weeds that has overgrown in here. So the water level is pretty low mixed with the chemical. So the bites, to me, that just seems like the bites can be way tougher. But you see they're jumping. What was that? What was that? Was that my stuff? No, stop. I'm going to pause. The weeds right there, let it drop. I don't know, punching just seems to be the trick right now. Yeah, I don't know. Maybe it's only my third catch. So many. Where are the bass? There's tons of bluegill here right now. All right. I'm going to do a couple more casts. Do a fan cast. Let's go this direction now. Thank you. you guys can see that. I don't think that's any bass over there, but I mean, I see them, but definitely looks like a school of bluegill, to be honest with you. I don't know, I think it's like 88 degrees here today, so. Yeah, I would love to throw a chatterbait in here, but it's so weedy. Oh, you gotta be kidding me. Come on. All right, I'll go. Let's see if maybe a faster. Oh! Okay, yeah, it's definitely topwater biting, for sure. So I thought this would be a good little surface deal. All right. So, they've got really good bass here, man. They got a, the biggest one I've caught out here is my PB. It was about 3.74, 3.75. It was like a year ago, but I've seen 6-pound bass get caught over there. All around this pond, man, it's nice. What a key here, right there. I'd say I'm about 3 feet, maybe 4 feet of visibility for sure. I mean, you can really see that color. No, okay, maybe not 4 feet. Come on. I'm bound to catch one on this color, man. I want to so bad. You know, one thing about these rods, man, they're so light. So light. And when you do catch one, a fish, you feel it into your hands and it goes all the way down your forearms. I mean, you can feel the grass, you can feel the rock, you can feel the weeds, you can feel yourself get hung up and pull through the weeds. I mean, it, oh, wow. sticks fishing rods, man. That's really good, really, really, really good. There's a jumper right there. That's where I need to go. On the outside of those coolies right there, that was a good jump, too. Anyway. Phenomenal rods and reels. I mean, sorry. Phenomenal rods. The reels are separate. So, again, it's called sticks fishing, man. If you guys ever need a good set of bass rods, I mean, there's six of them designed for each style of fishing. This is a finesse. The number two is a hybrid spin stick. The number three, it's a hybrid bait caster. And that's meant to throw all kinds of goodies. You know, your wackies, punching. You can punch on it, Texas rig it, chatterbaits, lipless crankbaits, or even deep diver squarebills. It's a good variety on the number three. I really like the number three a lot. The number four is your reaction, so more so your walking baits. Anything that's a reaction style bait, really. Number five is your surface rod, so I'm not fully understanding the surface rod just yet. I know it's good for top water. Definitely want to use braid. I'm sure you can use something that goes, you know, no more than a foot deep with the surface stick. I could be wrong. And then the number six is your power stick. You throw your big, big weighted baits on there. Not too big. But I punch with that as well. I've caught a few fish on that one. Just want to get one loaded up on here, especially for you guys watching. This is my actual first fishing video for YouTube and for you guys watching out there. So still working out the kinks, working out the nervousness. I don't really care if anybody sees me talking to myself. Doesn't bother me none. It's talking to the camera, I think, that kind of gets me going or gets me nervous. Let it go. No, just kidding, everybody. So, I just want to say one thing. I'm not affiliated with anybody here, okay? Not even with this company or anything. I just been loving their rods. They're phenomenal rods. They're $100 each, or you can buy all six for $500, and I think that's excellent deal. Excellent deal.